Hey guys, welcome back to the show. Today it's an opinion video about Pentax, and this is based 100% on my own feelings. I haven't read anything, I don't have any physical proof. It's just my idea about what might happen with Pentax in the film world. And yes, Pentax doesn't make any film cameras at the moment, but let's get into it. So as always, let's start. The idea is that the other day I made a video about Nikon F6 being discontinued, probably for good. We still don't know 100% for sure from the Japan factory or Japan headquarters, but someone in the comments said, hey, you said something about Pentax, what is it? So watching a video on the Ricoh YouTube channel, I'll link that below and up here, there's a Pentax statement about the SLR system, the whole thing. Everybody in the digital world is moving to mirrorless. We have Canon with the R system or the RF system. We have Nikon with the Z. We have Sony with the Alpha. We have, you know, all these brands moving towards, and Pentax is still selling SLR cameras. They have the K1 and, you know, whatever else they have in the lineup. I'm not an expert on the Pentax line, but I think the K1 full frame digital camera. But what happens? They made this statement, they made this video about how pentaprisms are super important. Actually, Pentax comes from pent and prism. So they think the actual future of photography could also still have a lot to do with SLR. Because when you're using an SLR, you're seeing through the lens. You're not seeing what the sensor sees and an EVF on the screen or on your eye, which sometimes is super confusing. I'm not a big fan of it. And they say, you know, Pentax brought the pentaprism first when there was rangefinder cameras only, and they were, you know, coming to an end of their life cycle, which they're still around, but you know what I mean. And in that video, there's a bunch of people shooting, and there's a whole statement about how they feel about it. And there are a lot of film cameras in that, because of course, Pentax made a lot of film cameras, the famous K1000, we have the Pentax 645, we have the Pentax 6x7 that I have here. And they made even the 110 SLR little camera with a whole system of lenses that you can interchange and whatnot. So Pentax is saying that their future is still with SLR cameras, that they're not gonna abandon that, that the future is still with that. So the thing that I noticed when I watched the video, and I never watched this kind of digital stuff, I don't really watch that kind of stuff. And I was watching it and I couldn't help but see a ton of film cameras. And there was either one of two things: that they're really, you know, remember the past and they respect the past and where they came from and whatnot, which I totally respect. Or it's a hint of, yeah, we're doing digital bodies, but who knows if we might bring something out again. And that could be a hint. I could not be. I take it as a hint. I want to be, I'm always super optimistic about the film world. With the whole thing about Olympus and selling some of their business to a different person. I made a video which got a lot of views from you guys, which I honestly appreciate. Then about the Nikon F6, and it was the last true, very modern SLR camera. There's no other one right now except for the Leica rangefinders, which are not exactly what I would consider like super high-end, like workhorse. Like, it is a workhorse for what it is, but it's not like, you know, doesn't accept like, it has something that's not exactly the premium SLR camera like the F6. So Pentax, why would they make a camera? First of all, Pentax hasn't really cared much sometimes about making weird cameras. They have that little 110 camera, and they've done other experiments that have not always been too popular. The brand doesn't have a huge percentage of the sales of cameras in general. So they could bring a film camera. They could be the brand that brought film back on the table, back on the conversation. We guys know that film is still sold, that film is still shot, that there's problems to keep, production with the high demand that we have. There's more young people coming to a film, that they're happy with their phones, but they also want to shoot film, that it's become not a film versus digital and which one's better, but it's become like both can live together and it's super fun to have all the mediums. And Pentax might bring like a K1000 or another body that they could make that could accept a bunch of lenses that are out there. And not only that, but Pentax has two lenses still in the market that have aperture settings on the lens. They have the FA50 1.4 and the recently reintroduced 35 F2. Why would they bring a new lens or reintroduce a lens that and keep the ring? They could make it all automatic. On the K1, it would work perfectly fine, because it's an automatic camera. You can set it to aperture priority or shutter priority or all manual or program, whatever you want. But why keep those settings? Keep those manual rings. Maybe they might bring something. That's where and this was a comment that someone left that they said about the lenses. I didn't know about it. So maybe they're gonna make it. And remember, Pentax also made the Pentax Q, which was that super small little camera that resembled the 110. Like, they're not too scared to make something different, to maybe not sell huge volumes like Canon or Nikon or Sony have to sell thousands and thousands of cameras and they have to go pushing the top, you know, like the flagship stuff. But Pentax maybe can bring something that's not flagship, that's film. It might not be like with all the bells and whistles that like the Nikon F6 had, but maybe it would have like a light meter, a shutter speed that goes to 1/2000 of a second. It has flash syncs to like 1/250th or 1/25th, like something simple. And there's another thing, and that's the last thing I'll say. Most of the people shooting film nowadays are buying secondhand, but a lot of people want to buy new. A lot of people, and then schools, universities, all these places can't buy secondhand so easily. They have to buy new. And that's why we have brands making enlargers still and making film washers and making film tanks and all these products that sometimes you look at them or easels and you think, who's buying that new? Well, there's schools, colleges, like university, all these places buy new. They have to. Reflex, the camera system that's trying to bring back the Reflex camera that's having all the troubles, and there's more info on that soon, is trying to make this camera because they had contracts to sell thousands of cameras to universities, colleges, schools, or high schools. So will Pentax take it? Will Pentax try to make a film camera? I think the market's absolutely open for them, even though we all have all the film cameras we could need and three times more. They're slowly breaking. They're slowly not getting parts. There's no spares. There's no things. So slowly the market is diminishing in amount of cameras. And if Pentax brought back a film camera, it would bring everyone's attention to Pentax. We could use those lenses. And then Pentax glass is superb. Like, and this is starting to be about the Pentax part, but like, why not? Why wouldn't they do it? And this is, I said, 100% my opinion, has nothing to do with what I know in any way, but I'm hopeful that Pentax might pull it through. I think they're the brand that could do it. So that's my opinion video. Hope you enjoyed it. I know I derailed a little bit. That's what happens when I give my opinions without having any script at all, except for a couple notes here and there. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Remember, this show runs mostly on Patreon support. If you feel like supporting, you can check it out. And also, it's an opinion video. Leave your opinion. Let me know. Am I totally wrong? You think I'm right? Maybe it could happen. Maybe we'll see a K1000. Maybe we won't. I want to know. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one. Bye.